Hello, everybody. I have a huge transmission, if you will, for everybody. Instantly, the name that popped in my head, my third eye, was the Great Transformation. Now, I've seen here and there, I haven't watched anything, but I have seen, titles of videos that scan through YouTube that are saying, some big event that's going on. I never really looked into that. I've been busy with other things, and I focus on what surfaces organically from spirit. And well, it made its presence known. And it's humbling. And it is very satisfying to the soul that the light of the spirit is shining on it. And that's what it feels like when you get such an obvious message from Universal Oneness, not just from guides. We're talking archangels, ascended masters, from source itself. And it's massive. There's millions of beings of light at work here. So the great transformation is happening within each and every one of you. I was clearly shown hundreds of thousands of crows. And the crow, a lot of you may know, death, transformation, shadow side of you. I saw some crows bigger than other crows, and when I asked, I was shown 144,000. There were the bigger crows. And the smaller ones, all still from light worker, light body, beings of love, empaths, whatever you want to call them. We're shown as not necessarily smaller, but just not as on the front line as others. So I'm seeing just like a wave of, fifth, sixth, whatever dimensional beings coming across the sky, for example, waves of millions, right? It's the visual of that wave coming from light workers, empaths that are on the earth. So there's a front line, if you will. So there are the whole 144,000 light workers is a massive activation going on, but it's everybody. And what does that activation do? Well, that activation brings us into the shadow side of ourselves. Now, I don't want people to get the wrong idea when I say the whole front line. And a wave. This message isn't based around a battle or a warrior stance, readiness, mentally and emotionally. That is not the time for this. Yes, we are going through the biggest battle, spiritually, energetically. But this is a inner transformation. As well as a external or a mass consciousness or a collective transformation. But we like to speak directly to you, the individual that is listening to this right now, that what you, yes, you will be experiencing this externally, seeing it on TV, experiencing, the repercussions of everything that's been going on. through the transformation of the third dimensional matrix, if you will. But this is something that's going to feel really intense with the self. You may have already gone through this. You may be going through it now, or you may be on the cusp of going through this. But this is the deepest level of shadow work, if you will, that we have ever experienced. And you can look at the soul being from light. Okay, the spirit comes from higher self. Okay, higher self, Holy Spirit. So you're going to visualize that as like sparkling golden white light, that this energy has stardust on it, if you will. It's you. It's your consciousness. It's your awareness. It's your I am. Your higher self comes from that. And then the spirit comes from the higher self. Some people, you know, may say that the spirit is the higher self, explaining this as it's trickling down. Then from the spirit comes the soul, and the soul is what breaks through the fifth into the fourth and the fourth to the third and becomes a living human. Okay, but the soul, or the ego, you could think of it, is connected to the higher self. And the amnesia that we volunteered for when we came to this planet happened between the higher self and the soul, when the soul extended from the higher self and came into your physical body. So the soul is in the physical form, if you will, is the clouds, the mist that appears in the first stages of manifestation out of ether. This is dreamland. This is astral plane type of energy. The soul, the ego, the spirit is the higher self coming in, the light that's coming in. And the light that's coming in is unprecedented right now. Look at the earthquakes, the tsunamis, the avalanches, the volcanoes, the disruptions, the protests, everything that's going on out there. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. That's what this light is. It's a swarm of beings of love. Call them angels, ascended masters, whatever you want to call them. Well, there's waves of us waking up as well. That light coming in is the greatest transformation. This is at the highest frequency than ever before. Therefore, we are going into the deepest, sludginest, darkest caverns of your subconscious. And the crow symbolizes the through air. Air is often associated with spirit, and so do birds. But the crows are carrying over the dark subconscious into the conscious. So a lot of this can be happening within dreams. Your abilities are expanding, so the dreams are going to be magnified. How else do you know yourself unless through experiencing these dark shadows? How else do you know yourself unless you have the experience of knowing yourself within these circumstances? I am seeing a caterpillar turning into a butterfly. So your mental, emotional, sometimes physical layers are being surfaced. Your deepest traumas, your deepest fears. But I'm being shown these crows taking flight. Taking flight and organizing together. hundreds of thousands at this time. Understand that this is trauma and fear and hurt, and awakening hurts. Transformation, painful. It's a death. It's the death of an old self, death of the ego, or death of a perception or a belief or a light. Certain things, certain lights are not seen by all. When the darker of a situation you may find yourself, light can be really dim and you'll see it when you're in such darkness. But when you're in bright light and you look towards that dim light, you're not going to see it. And we increase in vibration into brighter light. Be gentle with yourself. Let yourself feel. Let yourself allow. Let yourself go. Letting go of control. And this death experience is, it is like a death. So it's emotional. It's letting a persona or an alter ego, or letting the pain body go. This is all necessary in order for all of you to feel the miracles, to feel the beauty of inner transformation, of your God light moving into yourself. So you can become the highest vibration of your truth, your true authentic self, your higher spirit moving in the physical body, embracing and healing the soul. And when they become one, you soar. You are all going to next levels of your ascension and your spiritual path. A lot of you are light workers, readers, mediums, channelers. Nurses, good people, you know, this is people that have light in them. They don't necessarily have to be channelers or readers. There's millions of us. There's millions that are just awakening. Please understand, you are not at the end of your path. You are at the beginning of a brand new path, a path of all paths. So if you could think of your birth till now, that's one path. Give or take a few months, one way or the other, you're going through the death, if you will, of the old path and the beginning of a new one, which is around now, give or take a few months to the rest of your life. We are at a time of the biggest crossroads we've ever seen within our individual paths and as a collective. All of this is doing is to get you to happiness, to bring you to abundance. And it may feel like intervention, a spiritual intervention, to where you have to be stripped of everything that is comfortable to you. And you may feel, why, God? Why stripping me from everything? And God's doing you a favor. It's to show you, it's to bring healing to the deep wounds that you have covered with many layers of energetic, dense scar tissue. It's like ripping off a band-aid mentally and emotionally. But please know, you are in the arms of love. And if you let go of what does not serve you, you will find that bliss that your heart, the essence of your entire being, is aching for. You have to be willing to let it all go. Then we can do the rest. Be gentle with yourself. And be excited that what you are experiencing is the beginning of your new life, the path of love, health, abundance, that inner mental peace that I think is the best of all, to feel centered with higher self and universal oneness and your spiritual path more than ever before. The carbon-based body is slowly being changed, displaced with crystalline light. DNA is changing, bodies are changing. Rest when you need to rest. It's hard to explain in words on this planet how much you are going through, how much you are experiencing physically, mentally, emotionally, energetically. This transformation, the transition process is brutal to the human. Your feelings are valid. Give yourself credit. You are going through more than you can possibly imagine. Caterpillar to a butterfly. Phoenix rising from the ashes. Love to everyone. And so it is done.